So this is the AirStash product. It is a wireless flash drive that lets you communicate to your mobile devices, like the iPad, iPhone, iPod Touch, and do several things. One is you can plug it, you can stream video directly off of it. You can browse and import photos, as well as you can communicate, save files back and forth from iWork applications, for example, using a technology called WebDAV. The other thing you can do is you can plug it in as a USB drive. So the key is it's the first and only USB drive for iPad, which is a problem people are having. Today, for me to get a file from myself to someone next to me, I have to go through the cloud. I have to go through email, or I have to sync through my laptop and iTunes. And if I don't have a laptop and I don't want to go through the cloud because it's, let's say, a 100 megabyte file, what do I do? And so the key is AirStash solves that problem to let you do it. And we can show you a demonstration if you'd like to do that.
Okay,
so I have AirStash here. Okay, I'm going to show you how we connect to it. So the way we connect is very simple. In this case, it's already connected, but we'll show you what you do. You go here, and it creates its own Wi-Fi network. So you'll see here, this is Matt's AirStash, which I've already connected to. There's a lot of stuff going on, I guess, today's show. Okay, once I'm connected, we have a couple ways of communicating. We have an app here. This is through the browser. I've created a bookmark here that connects through the browser. And so what this is bringing up is kind of like the root directory of my SD card. And it's all based on SD cards. And we'll take that out in a minute. But that SD card is what's being served. So essentially, I have access to everything on that SD card through AirStash. And I'll give an example first of a PDF. So here I have a couple of PDFs. I'll go ahead and bring up a file. It brings it right in. I can open it up in iBooks just like anywhere else, but you can see the file stream directly in. So for people that have lots of books, lots of content, works with eBooks as well, you go ahead and bring it in. So now let me go back. Over here. And I'll launch and go back and reconnect. It remembers where I was in my last area. And now let's go ahead and look at a movie. So first I'll show you just a short movie clip to do it really quick. I'm just going to quickly bring it up here, and it shows it up in this preview area. In the preview, I can watch it here, or I can go full screen. That's just a quick video clip, right? Showing that. We can also do things such as a larger movie. So I'll bring up a movie that I've done before. I'll bring up one of my favorite James Bond movies. And this one takes a little bit to load, especially once we have a lot of Wi-Fi communication going on, so I apologize, but let me go ahead. And again, you can see it in preview. But typically, I would keep this in my pocket, or I'd keep it in my briefcase, or backpack, or your purse. You can keep it wherever you need to and get access to it. So it's loaded up here. And I'm going to go ahead and bring it full screen. Now, this particular movie starts off in black and white. And I'll show you the ability. I'll scrub forward. So I can go ahead and tap. It takes a little bit to catch up here. Okay, wait a second. And go ahead and scrub and watch your movie. And I guess we're a little bit low on buffering. It's still buffering here due to
the signals here are crazy.
Yeah. So anyway, so you go ahead and watch your movie. Okay. So this is just an example of streaming. So if I have lots of gigabyte games that are moving more towards gigabyte games, and I want to store them, where do I carry my movies? Or let's say I'm using this for corporate, and I want to have all my personal products. I can keep all my personal movies, let's say a dozen or so, on my AirStash. And I do this with my kids. I load them up in the car. They're in the back seat. They can each pick a different movie and watch simultaneously different movies from AirStash. So it's much easier than syncing to each one and managing, you know, the content. It works with iTunes DRM content, but of course the movies, it only works with movies that are licensed for that particular unit. So if I bought one for my iPad, if I went ahead and tried to share it with a friend, obviously they're not authorized and it would block. But that does do that. Now I want to show you another example of the third thing we do, and it's going to be photos. So if I have a bunch of photos, particularly from the SD card from my camera, I'm able to just quickly bring them up, and I'll bring up some photos here. And I have a preview pane where I can look at preview of everything, or I can go to full screen and look at my pictures. And just scroll through it. And we have a slideshow mode. You can push play, and it will keep going through. And so the key here is really on the terms of photos. I can browse them, and again, this is browsing them without importing them. So I don't have to, if I have thousands of pictures, it's much easier to browse them. In fact, we have an app, which I'm about to show you, that's in alpha stage. We're going to be releasing it this month, that lets you bring in up to 35 megapixel pictures. And you can browse them. We got the feedback from professional photographers saying they would love to be able to browse lots and lots of photos, but not have to go through the whole lengthy process of importing them through the camera connection kit or trying to email them or resize them. So we can actually do that, and we'll show you a quick demonstration of that too. This is with an app that's in alpha mode. So it looks very similar. It's not optimized yet for iPad as of right now, but let me go ahead to photos. And same thing on the photos. If I'm already here, I can click. There's a new icon here called Import. And again, it's very crude in the beginning, but I can import it full size, meaning full resolution, or I can go ahead with, if I don't do full size, it'll optimize for the display of the device. So it'll bring it in the same resolution as an iPad or the same resolution as an iPhone 4, etc. So in this case, let me go ahead and import to current directory. Again, this is still alpha stage, so it'll just show you a progress bar bringing these in. I think I got about a dozen pictures or so. Okay, so fairly quick, again, without a laptop and going through iTunes. And now if I go over to my photo gallery, which I have somewhere here, there we go, little flower. I've got my photos. In fact, I think I imported these twice, unfortunately. But so you can see, I did bring them in again. And again, this is now using, you can use them in Zoom and use the standard photo application. So again, a convenience for photographers, etc. And so the example here, I'm going to pull this out. You know, this is the SD card I use. This happens to be an 8 gig card. You can go up to 32 gigabytes today. And we'll have expansion in the future as it becomes more popular, and the SDXC cards that go up to 2 terabytes. But they're a little costly now, so we're just waiting and working with what's available and what makes sense. Now, we got one last feature we'd love to show you.
Okay.
This is one of our premier features that we announced at the show, and I think we're going to use now. Should I take to you?
I'll keep this propped up here.
Okay.
All right. So with WebDAV, we can import and export documents from Apple iWork applications like Keynote directly from the AirStash. So it's just like a USB flash drive for your iPad. Go down here, choose Copy from WebDAV, and I'll see a list of everything on my card. Go to Documents. I'll pull in a little document that I made while I was on this shuttle over to CES this morning. So I made this one-slide presentation using a photo that I imported from my AirStash. Now, let's say I want to save a copy of this in PDF so that somebody else can preview it before we send it out. All I need to do here is go to Copy to WebDAV. You get your choice of format to export. This is part of the iWork apps. I'm going to choose PDF. I'm going to put it in my Documents folder again. We'll write the file onto the AirStash. And now I can use another WebDAV compatible app, like GoodReader. Come over here, choose my AirStash, choose Documents, and now I can see the PDF version of this. It'll download it. And now I have my presentation in GoodReader here as well. So it works with dozens of existing applications that are already available for the iPhone, iPod Touch, and iPad.
And this is a product that's going to, this particular feature will be released later this quarter. And the nice part is, again, you don't have to go to the cloud. And now that we've got it onto AirStash, you can just plug it directly into a laptop and drag and drop like a USB drive if you want. So it's your choice whether you want to use wireless directly to the existing apps, or you can go ahead and just work with a USB drive. It gives that flexibility to finally give the promise that you don't have to bring a laptop with you. iPad can be now your true laptop replacement, as long as you got an AirStash.